brothers and sisters, obedience comes in many forms. Sometimes we obey out of fear. Sometimes it comes out of love. Friends, we obey the rules on the road, not out of love, but because of the punishment that comes otherwise. So we obey the signs on the road. However, my friends, we would love to serve and obey our friends and family out of love. Love. Biblically, obedience comes out of love. One obeys because one loves. In the same way that we want to serve our friends, our spouses, because of our love for them, so our love for Christ should motivate our love for Christ should motivate It touches my heart to know that. One obey because one loves. In the same way we want to serve our friends and our spouses because of our love for them, so our love for Christ should motivate us to serve Him and obey His commands. We should obey God's commands. We should be obedient to God's commands. Obeying God is about a daily relationship with Jesus Christ. We need to read God's word every day and pray. We need to give our time, our talents, tithes, and offerings faithfully. We need to serve and share with others consistently. We need to share the gospel, my friends, with the world and bring His love to the people all around. Obedience is an act of worship. We can please by our obedience. We can please by our obedience. Lord Jesus says in John 14 and verse 15 that, and I quote, "If you love me, you will keep my commandments," unquote. When our obedience is based on love, it brings obedience, acceptance, and the understanding that God delights and rejoices in us. Friends, we obey because we love. God loves us because of who He is. God is love, and He needs us to love each other the same way. We must love. There's no room in this world for hate. Love. Obey. Brothers and sisters, my wife and I have always tried our best to instill good manners and a high expectation of obedience for our kids. "I obey right away" is a common phrase we hear in our home. Obedience. We make sure our kids obey, have respect, love, honor. That's the key about obedience. God wants us to love. Friends, when our obedience is based on love, it brings confidence, acceptance, and the understanding that God delights and rejoices in us. Friends, children should obey their parents because it is the right thing to do as it pleases the Lord. Just as in Colossians chapter 3:20 and Ephesians 6:1 tells us, but as a child of God, this expectation is still in place throughout our whole life. Obedience, brothers and sisters, can often seem like a chore or a burden, but it is truly, truly the mark of a mature Christian. Obedience. Let's learn to obey. We must learn to love. There's too many hates in the world today. Too many things are going on. Love. If we all have love, if we obey God's command, all of us will have a better world. A united world. A world of love, peace, joy, respect. Your growth in Christ relies greatly on your commitment to think, worship, and work rightly. Friends, God wants us to learn how to obey Him. But we must remember that obedience is the fruit of salvation. Obedience is the fruit of salvation. Our good works will never earn right standing before God. Apart from our faith in the finished work of Christ, our righteous deeds will always fall short of God's holiness. And if you want to know more about this, just read Isaiah 64. But because we will fall short of God's holiness does not mean that He hasn't called us to be holy just as He is. God is holy. He wants us to be holy. My friends, this process of continuing to grow in Christ and walk in obedience is called sanctification. Sanctification. It is a Christian growth in grace to become more Christian-like day by day. So since God has deposited in us salvation, we must cooperate with God. We must cooperate with God's work for God to work it out, to bring it into fullness and completion with sustained effort and diligence by the power of His Holy Spirit. Obedience means a lot to God. Obedience means a lot for us as Christians to grow in obedience, obey the command of God. If we just read the Bible, it tells us everything. You know, when I was preparing, the reason why I prepared this topic today, obedience, is because in our Bible, in our prayer meeting in the mornings, we have different topics. And it's so interesting to know that each one of these topics, which is trust, obey, everything, you find them so many parts of the Bible, from the Old Testament to the New Testament. The Old Testament tells you what and what's coming. The New Testament brings you further into what's going on today. It's very intriguing, very interesting to compare, to see the Old Testament to the New Testament. The Apostle Paul shares with the Philippians that it isn't enough to proclaim your salvation, but as believers, we should see it worked out in our lives, bearing fruit for all to see. Therefore, my friends, my beloved, as you have always obeyed, so now, not only as in my presence, but much more in my absence, work out your own salvation with fear and trembling, for it is God who works in you both to will and to work for His pleasure. These words are not my words. They are the book of Philippians. Philippians 2:12-13. Please read it when you have time. God give us grace and His Spirit, so we do not have to walk out this calling alone or powerless, my friends. Even though we are partnering with God in our sanctification, but ultimately he's the one who is doing the work in us, transforming our old ways and conforming us to look more like Him, Christ. Obedience is important, my friends. Friends, your dependence upon the Lord, which is not passive, but an active cooperation between you and God. It's between you and God. It empowers your obedience and develop your sanctification, all for God's glory. God desire relationship with you and is pleased with your obedience because you are His child and because you care to walk in His ways. My friends, one of the many ways to worship and glorify God is through obedience. Obedience. Living in obedience to God is all the things, even the mundane, is a great way to show your love and respect for God. Obedience, my friends, is also a suited way to draw nearer to Him and grow in your relationship with Him. For many reasons, obedience is an important part of our Christian relationship with Christ. If we obey God, if we listen to His command, if we follow His instruction, God promised that everything that you do will be given to you. He will do anything for you because He knows He never leave us. He's always there. Always. You know, sometimes we ask God for something, and because we don't have that patience, and some of us don't have trust in God, and what happens, you expect an answer right away. But brothers and sisters, that answer doesn't come all the time. Because God has each and every one of us plan written out there. Before you ask for it, before whatever has happened to you, it's going to happen, but it's not going to happen before God's time. Because He said, before one tip of my word pass away, heaven and earth will. God's word never fails. It's going to be precise, at the right time, at the right place, for everyone. Obedience to God is not only a way to worship Him, but a way to get closer to Him. Preparing for whatever He leads you to, and grow as a person. As Christian saints, We know we are not saved by our works, but that our faith without works is dead. Our faith without works is dead. That's what the Bible said, James chapter 2. Obeying God should not be a burden, but rather a joy. A way of worshiping Him and growing in His faith. Ultimately, my friends, we'll feel more satisfied when we are in right relationship to God, which can only come through obedience. Obedience. That's what Deuteronomy says. True obedience. My friends, 1 Samuel 15 and verse 22 reminds us that, and I quote, "To obey is better than sacrifice," unquote. To obey is better than sacrifice. What God is trying to teach us, my friends, or teaches the Israelites here, is that He wants them to obey far more than He wants them to pay for their sins through sacrifice. The same is true for us, my friends. Obedience is one way we show God that we believe He will do what He says He will do. I just said it. Whatever, if you obey God, whatever God says for you, it will happen. We only have to trust and obey and be patient, because no one can rush His God. Everything is on His time. It is one way we can outwardly show our inward disposition towards God. God does not forgive us when we mess up, but His desire that we strive first to not mess up. This is where choices comes in. We just don't jump to conclusion until we make the right choice. We think about it. And if you can't get an answer, you ask God to guide you with this. And God will lead you the right way. That is how we demonstrate true belief in God. Friends, God created man to rule over the earth. He created us to shepherd the animals and work the ground. God certainly does not need us to take care of His creation, as He is almighty. He's almighty and powerful. But He asks us to do it anyway. He doesn't need us, but He asks us to do it anyway. Genesis chapter 2 and verse 15 tells us more about it. But why is that? One answer is that God is calling us to obedience and relationship with Him through obedience. By obeying His call to take care of this earth, we learn more about Him and can grow in understanding of His heart and desire for our lives. I'm not going to keep you too long. Obedience also leads to personal growth. Every command God asks of us isn't just for His sake, but for ours. The call to obedience is for our benefits. He knows what is best for us and how to grow us to be stronger people and followers of Christ. The scripture says, if you fully obey the Lord your God and carefully keep all His commands that I am giving you today, the Lord your God will set you high above all nations of the world. You will experience all these blessings if you obey the Lord your God. God says, your town and your field will be blessed. Your children and your crops will be blessed. The offspring of your herds and flocks will be blessed. Your fruit basket and breadboards will be blessed. Wherever you go, my friends, and whatever you do, you will be blessed. So I close this morning in obedience demonstrates our faith and trust in God. Obedience is the key to our success. Obedience is a sure and promised way for unlocking blessings for our lives. Friends, for us to be able to fully obey, we must read His word every day, and ask God to empower us with His Holy Spirit, so that our lives, my friends, is going to honor Him, God the Almighty. Amen.